Primary School. I'm Pascual Damanazo, Primary 5, also from Emin Primary School.
Now we'll still be at
Calculus
Chapter 7,
Double and Triple Integral.
So last few lessons, what we learned?
For these lessons of double integral, we have learned a lot, many ways.
Yes.
And right now, I'll give some examples of the methods that we have learned. But always, you need to look at the integral region.
Yep.
The integrand.
Right? Yes.
And double integral, you always need to change it into iterated integral.
Of course. If not, what should we do?
And then after that, first method.
Changing. Is it changing from Cartesian to polar?
Well, that is another way, okay?
Okay.
The first method, which I actually wanted to say, is that you have to be aware of the order.
Okay.
Because at different order, they might mean different answers.
Different
and one order might be right, the other might be wrong.
Okay.
So first method is actually what I say it as. It depends on the order.
Okay, so the first method is order method.
Okay, and then the second, which as you just said,
the polar and Cartesian.
You can change Cartesian to polar. When?
Only when
the integral region is a circle, a ring, right?
Or a ring, you mean?
Okay.
You know what a circle ring?
Which is actually all those x squared plus y squared, right?
Yes.
Then how about the third? What is actually the symmetric property?
Yes.
If the integral region is symmetric about whatever you're having first, and the integrand is an odd function, you can actually just throw away sub as a zero, because it is symmetric. At this part, you can find two opposite pieces, right?
Or sometimes you could just split it into two or more regions.
Okay, so these two, they might just cancel it out. And that is actually what gives it a zero, right?
Yes.
There, how you just said, you can separate them into different regions.
Yep.
That is another one, okay?
Okay.
So actually we already have these four of them, right?
Right. Worth.
So for this, we'll have one example over here. So for this, I'll first draw that integral region. Let me just redraw this.
Okay. Maybe above is a bit too thin. Yeah,
like this.
Compass.
So for this, we have two different methods.
One is first x and the other?
First y.
Okay. So here, we'll refer to the first method with the first x, okay?
Okay. So for this one, it is first with respect to x.
We did the first method, write it down, the first method, method one. Write down method one. And the question which is double integral, the integral region which is x squared plus y squared is big, I mean smaller or equals to a squared, and a must be bigger than zero, and the integral which is bracket x modulus xy modulus plus x plus y bracket dx dy. Actually, with respect to.
So we can separate them first?
Yes.
And this is it, right?
Yep.
Them into three parts, right?
Yes.
Which is A, B, and C.
Okay, I'm sure that B and C, do you know why it is zero?
Wait, first, okay. So you said that there will be zeros, right?
You know why?
Why?
Look, with respect to Y, x is considered an odd function and plus is symmetrical, so zero. And thus, first we use first x, which make it which still symmetrical means a zero.
Well, for this part, I'll go first according to the x, okay?
Okay.
So here, if you integrate first with respect to x, what happens?
Okay, so you'll do everything with respect to x, okay?
Well, some parts I still need with respect to y.
Later, with respect to y. You'll use with respect to x, okay?
So actually, at this part, just need to see. That is an odd function. This is symmetric. So it's actually, you can just straight away say it as zero.
Do you know why? Because that, for example, something like over here, it's also symmetrical, which here.
And then they can cancel out.
Yes, and become a blank.
And that is actually what makes it zero, right?
Yeah. But later you'll notice you use x to this, it's a zero, so use x to this also a zero.
So at this part, this a is equal to, well, let's see. At this part, x and y, they might be positive, they might be negative.
Yep.
So I need to see about those different quadrants, right?
Yes, that's right. Yes, that's right.
Is this right up to now?
Yes. quadrants?
Which is actually four different parts, right?
Yes.
And then after that, for each of this part, you can see whether positive or negative.
Yes.
So for the first quadrant, which X and Y, they are both positive, right?
Yep.
So if they are false positive, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
And for this part, this we need to know. What do we need to know? What function this is, right?
Yeah. So we'll find what x equals and what y equals, okay?
For this method, we only need to know what x is.
Okay.
So here, what is the negative square root a square minus y square? And here is the square root a square minus y square. Just a difference of that negative. Okay?
Okay.
So right at this point, we can sub that in, right?
Okay.
So when we sub this in, this x and the y stays there, right? Now it's just the problem for the boundaries, right?
Yes.
First quadrant, x is from 0 to curve. That means negative square root a square minus y square. And therefore y is 0 all the way until... Did you realize the mistake?
Wait, something's wrong here.
Why is the extra negative?
Why is it negative even though it's of the origin? Plus, let me ask you.
Yes?
Why is the modulus still there?
Which part?
The first step.
So this, I just separate them into different quadrants. Okay.
Okay.
And the second quadrant, x is a negative, y is a positive. So this turns out to be a negative.
Yep, back, back.
So for x, it goes from, hello?
Okay. What?
From?
Nothing. Nothing wrong.
I'm asking you, x is from?
Oh. So you say x from, right?
Yes.
So x from, wait, why is it a positive to a zero? Why is it a positive something to a zero? I thought a zero to that positive something or a negative something to a zero. Or goodbye bye. Like this.
Well, actually, I wrote this as the opposite.
Oh, that's a bit positive. Positive.
Like this. So here is actually a positive.
Okay.
So why? What is it?
I'm trying over here.
Well, that's exactly what I was asking you. Okay, so now you have this.
Okay.
For the third quadrant, are you really sure that yet? Third quadrant. Both are negative. Negative, negative, positive. So this is still a negative. Yes, positive.
Okie dokie.
So for the part at the back, which is actually for the fourth quadrant. So you can stop here now.
So explain.
So at this part, you just integrate first.
Okay.
Because that from double, we've already changed it into iterator. Then next, we need to change it into
single.
Yes.
Single.
Is there anything wrong?
No. Yeah, definitely something wrong.
Next, for this part.
Wait.
Not
wait.
Equals yet.
You can do that.
Oh well. So you combine those together.
Okay.
But now I have a problem with the region is in the seam.
Oh. Let me see then. Okay, fine.
Wait a second. Negative to zero.
Yeah, it's correct.
Well, this is.
Wait a second. Wait, this. Oh. I just kidding. You win. I'm just kidding.
Okay. Like this.
Okay.
Like this, is it right?
Yes.
So at this part, you just need to set them in, right?
Yep.
First part, is it right?
Okay.
And then after that, so from this, when you start that in, actually negative, right?
Yes.
Like this. for the second term.
Yes.
And then after that, this will also become a minus, right?
Of course. I got a shortcut here. I said.
Okay, so you said you have a shortcut, but first you need this step, okay?
Okay. Even though I got one.
Okay, so you can say what is your shortcut now.
Okay, so this part here, I do here, no knee. Here, no half, no half.
Which part no knee?
Here.
Why?
Because actually shift this. Actually, it's not that part. The reason I tell you is actually this part.
This part.
You know why? Yes, because then you could just shift here, put here, and shift here to here.
Okay.
And
so,
no half, no half.
So then you just combine them, right?
Yes. I have a combination. Okay, correct.
So like this, and then after that, you just need to integrate that, right?
Yeah.
Then after that, what happens? Here is the y to the power of 4.
Okay.
Then here you minus that half a square y square, and you start from negative a all the way to 0, and then which is plus 1 over 4 y to the power of 4. Then you start from negative a all the way to 0, right?
Okay.
So right now at this part, these two, can you combine them?
Yes.
So when you can combine them, what actually happens? Are you sure you can combine them?
Yeah.
Be sure? This is a to the power of 4 over 2, right?
Okay.
This is minus a to the power of 4 over 4.
Something fishy is going on. Okay, correct. So under here, correct. Nothing wrong.
So this part is actually all become a to the power of 4, then it is either over 2 or over 4.
Yes. Okay. Correct.
So like this, it just become a to the power of 4 minus a to the power of 4 over 2. to the power of 4 over 2, right? Am I right?
Yes.
Stand up.
So this is just the first part, which is A, okay?
Okay, now what? B, B, C, C. You should have know what is B. You should have know what is C.
Okay, so let me see here. For this.
Okay, so actually it means by first quadrant and second quadrant will combine, and third quadrant and fourth quadrant can combine to show that it's actually a zero.
Okay, so you're saying the upper part and lower part.
Yeah.
Right? So like this, and then after that, becomes like this, right?
Okay.
And then? Third and fourth, right?
Okay.
Still like this, right?
Yes.
So right now at this part, which is for that X, and can you come here?
Okay.
Tell me, first and second, how should we calculate about this?
So yes, first X.
Okay, first X. But what are these boundaries?
Boundaries easy. From this to this.
Which is?
From the negative to the positive part. Yes.
Then for this y, it is from 0 to 8, right?
Yes. Yes.
Like this, is it right?
Yep, 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 puppy.
So actually what happens? Don't erase that.
Okay, if you say so.
So at this part, which actually just becomes, what does it actually become? Well, so actually you could just combine them together.
Wrong. You shouldn't combine them. First integrate. First integrate.
Integrate.
You should have written here. But if you had no, that is actually a zero. Do you know why?
Okay, so x becomes an x square, right?
Yes.
So when x becomes an x square, no matter what you sub in, they're minus, right?
Yeah.
So when they're minus,
it'll be back. Never. The CCTV. I meant by C. So
let me write this down first. So far, we have only got one of them. So
one
C is now become 1 and 4, 2 and 3.
Okay. That's not an X, that's a Y.
Like this, right?
Yes.
And then after that, so I'll just erase the A first.
I said it straight away zero.
Okay, so straight away got a zero. How did you get it? Okay, so from this, you just need to, look at the symmetrical property, right?
Yes.
So far for this lesson, are you clear?
Yes, and next time we'll continue
with the second method.
Okay, which?
And this is actually just answer. Okay?
Yep.
So, if you like our video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Hope you like our video.
Stay tuned for more.
Okay. Thank you for your watching.